right, it's Nicole Hagee's birthday. We're at NCM Motorsports for the first drive with a Lotus. It is bone stock. Just wanted to kind of see what it does. Lotus says they only make race cars that are ready for the track. So we're going to test that out today. session in the Lotus. First time on the track. It is a new car. It has never been on a track before. And I've never driven a Lotus before, period, until I just bought this. I've never even seen one. And anyway, it was very surprising for me. With all the work I have in that BMW, I really thought the BMW would outperform this. In power, the vet is closer to the power of my M3, so the vet was pulling on me in the straights, as you'll see in the video, but in the corners I was all over him and could have passed him just about any time. This handles a lot better than the BMW in corners on a racetrack. So I previously took this to the Dragon and I made a comment that this does not handle as good because it was sliding around a lot, probably because these tires are cup twos and they don't reach the temperature they need to stick very well. On a racetrack, they definitely stick very well. I started in sport mode, which is full power, but a little bit of nannies turned on so you don't spin out. And then I switched it to race mode for the last lap just to see what it would do. And honestly, I couldn't tell a big difference. The tires are sticky, so I wasn't sliding anywhere. The vet was also holding me back a little bit, which is good, you know, but we probably didn't hit more than, I don't know, 120 miles an hour. But I don't know, this car just wouldn't go very fast in the straights. That's all it had. So I feel like it could use some more power in the straights, but on the corners, this thing is insane. How was it? It was your first time on in a race car on a racetrack, so how was it for you?
Fast and scary. You were going to flip over.
You thought you were going to flip over? You're going to flip over? What do you mean, just turning, or when I hit the rumble strips and like bounce sideways? So I hit those on purpose. If you take those wide, your car kind of just drifts, and sometimes it'll drift off the road if you're going too fast. So when I hit that curb, it's almost like it ramps the car up in the air and the tires smash down. And I'm putting this in layman's terms. I'm sure there's a race term for this, but anyway, it grips a lot better. So that's why I would hit those rumble strips and help me hold on to the road a little bit better.